Hey guys, I figured I would go over the installation of this GREE 1 month later and tell you how it's doing during what we call extreme cold weather, 17 degrees. If you haven't seen the video when I installed that, look up here. Here we go. All right, so first we installed this with no electric heater kit on it because it's rated for 95 degree air down to like -4 degrees Fahrenheit, and we only saw like Christmas weekend 17 degrees, which is about as cold as it gets down here. And in case you're wondering, it did just fine. It never blew cold air and it maintained 70 degrees or 68, wherever we set it, the entire time. One of the reasons it never blows cold air, it does go through defrost, is because if you don't have a heater kit plugged up to it, when this sends a signal through its defrost wire, it goes into the air handler and the air handler stops blowing when it goes through defrost, and it don't come back on until the air is warm again. So, but if you have a heat kit, it works like a normal air handler going through defrost. It will energize the heat strips. Now, we've been running it in cool and heat throughout the last month, and we do that all winter long. The days that we run just heating are very limited. There's probably going to be about 20 of those in a year, but getting down to 17 degrees, it maintained 70 degrees no problem, as long as I could convince my wife to keep the window shut. But it did just fine. I do encourage you to go look at the video where we installed this, and I'm gonna show you my generator setup and how I had it set up, and it ran my whole house without having to take it off electronic speed control. I'm gonna show you that here in just a second. First, before I get into that, I used, this is a Rector Seal RSH50 VRM kit, so it's a voltage regulator and monitor. And I wanted to show you, let me see if I can show you where I have it set. I have it set on 258 volts as my high and my low at 208. Now normally, as you see here, my voltage right now is reading 251, and if I, that was 252 there for just a second. It has tripped on high when I had it set on 254. I had it at 265 and the factory rep told me that was too high. So I dropped it to 258, which is about as low as I can take it with my voltage readings right here. Like, that's already 253.2. But that right there has already saved me a couple times. I had it set as low as 254 once, and that caused me to have a cold night because it tripped. But like I said, I'm gonna show you that generator setup I have and how it does. I'll describe that to you. All right, so first in here, I have a breaker interlock, and as you see, I have to turn off my main in order to turn on this breaker, and that's where my generator is. Now let's walk out. This has a disconnect under the porch, and this is my generator wire hookup. And they make generator wires just for that, and it plugs up. Forgive my porch, y'all, it's a mess. And it plugs up right here. Now when I crank this up, I have to turn off the electronic speed control and that makes it rev to the highest level. Before, I had to leave that on in order to run my air conditioner. Now I can crank this, turn on my electronic speed control so it idles down, and because I have the inverter driven air conditioner, this will just speed up gradually as the air conditioner speeds up. All right, because I have no heater kit in my air conditioner, I can run my air conditioning, my heat, my entire kitchen, all my lights, my entertainment center, basically like I have utility power just from this generator. It can go up to 30 amps. The air conditioner, when it's on really high speed, pulls about 16 amps. The whole thing, condenser and air handler. So that gives me another 14 I can spend on, and that's 14 amps at 240 volts. So it's really like another 28 amps on 120. I just may not be able to run my dryer and the air conditioner at the same time. But yeah, it turns out to be a really nice setup. Now the way I have it, I have dependable power even if the lights go out, and I can run my air conditioning and my heat. And I can turn the electronic speed control to on, and that way it saves gas. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like these kinds of videos, or if you like this kind of setup that I have, how about hit a like and subscribe? I'll catch you all in the next one.